Welcome back, everybody, to the Johnny Guitar Channel. Today, we are playing Baldur's Gate, the original. There's a reason for this.
I've
been thinking a lot about Baldur's Gate. I've been playing Baldur's Gate 3, as you guys know. And prior to that, I was playing the original Baldur's Gate and Baldur's Gate 2, Shadows of Aum. And so I kind of just wanted to...
We're all doomed. What is the point?
Just kind of wanted to revisit this first game. Okay. Just figuring out the buttons here, everybody. It actually has been a long time since I've played this game. Okay.
By Tempest Shield,
nature's servant awaits.
Okay. Because yes, I'm playing Baldur's Gate 3 with a character named Liar Jane. And this is actually the first time I created a Liar Jane character was here in the original Baldur's Gate. Oh yeah. So, let's see. What am I looking for? Mage Spells Journal. I should travel to Larswood or Peldvale next. It appears that the bandit attacks come from there and are related to the iron shortage. There should be a base hidden somewhere in the forests. Okay. That sounds important.
Seldom do I find so little fault with someone. I hope it lasts.
Okay. So in the last episode, I went down into the, I believe the Nashkel Mines, and we were able to, oh, there we go, that's the bandit camp. Okay, so, can I get back to the Friendly Arm Inn? Okay, the bandit camp is unreachable, which seems weird to me. Do I have to go to High Hedge? Let's at least explore here around the friendly camp. Now, one thing I do like about Baldur's Gate is it doesn't hold your hand. We're already starting a fight. Now, a big difference between this original Baldur's Gate and Baldur's Gate 3 is it's actually not quite turn-based. It's a little more chaotic. It always pauses right before combat, and then... Wait, how do I unpause? Options.
For the Fallen!
I shall.
Yeah, your character is just kind of attack things, but they all attack in their own unique way. They have their own kind of AI programming, and you can change it if you like to, but you know, mages are going to cast spells. A lot of times they'll first cast like mage armor, and then they'll start casting offensive spells. Imowen, because she has a bow, she's going to kind of stay back and arrow people. So it is a little more controlled, but it's definitely not turn-based, but somewhere in the background, the dice are rolling. It is still very much a D&D game, of course.
Onwards to humanity.
No, keep fighting, you guys. Oh, you guys are terrible. Flame dance ring, you say? Is check out this flame dance ring. Probably inventory, I imagine. Ring is a small band. Cool. I am well aware of ring. Okay, it's specific to this Joa woman. Okay. Well, can I take... Cool, I do have a gem bag. Another gem. Mulahe's holy symbol. The symbol is a representation of the god Sirik. Okay, is it like a piece of paper, or is it like a stone tablet, or like a necklace? One thing I do not understand about this original Baldur's Gate is I don't fully understand, sorry, I'm just looking at my phone here. I don't fully understand how fast travel works in this game, but we're figuring it out. Okay, everybody attack that dude. Go at it. So as you can see, battles are quicker. They're also quicker the other
way. My blade will cut you down to size.
Great job, Liar Jane. Liar Jane is a bard, but I'm pretty sure I just have her. Let's actually look at... She's a Scald, which is Warrior Bard. Awesome, Jane. Awesome, high strength. She's got Mind Shield, I guess. I don't know what any of this means, really. A little bit of pickpockets, okay, well let's... Scald is a Nordic bard. Oh, that is awesome, I should do a, I should do a Skyrim version of Liar Jane. Haha, just joking. If you watch the Johnny Guitar channel, we already have a Skyrim version of Liar Jane. We've also got some Fallout versions of Jane, as well as Fallout 4. Check out the Johnny Guitar channel. I play a lot of Fallout, Elder Scrolls, and I guess now Baldur's Gate. Okay, let's go through all of our characters, because once again, it has been a while. Liar Jane, the Scald. Jaira, the Fighter. Level 2, that's it. That's it. Her husband, Khalid. Also a fighter. Cool, two fighters. You guys are awesome. Bronwyn is a priest of Tempest. Level 3. So a cleric, right? Right? Is that what that means? Imowyn, who, according to the story here, is essentially... Why do we all have 25 strength? There must be some sort of spell in effect. Imowyn is our, like, sister, in a way. I mean, we were both adopted, but... For all purposes, she is our sister, and she is a thief. Zahn is someone we rescued from the Nashkel Iron Mines. Mel, he's an elf, and he is an enchanter. So useless. Okay. And in the last episode, which once again was months ago, if I remember correctly, there is an iron shortage here in the land. And, we went down to the Nashkel Mines to investigate said iron shortage, and it turns out that there's some mage who is purposely tainting the iron. And I guess we're on the trail of figuring out exactly who is doing this. Okay, can I do it? Sweet. Let's go to Peld Vale. Okay, is this a town? What is this? It's nighttime. It's a little scary. It's a little scary. Oh, there's a thing. There's
worry
a thing
not.
I can grab. What do we got? 10 gold. Take it. You know, when you first pop into these new map areas, I always get a little nervous because there is a town around here somewhere, but I could also be walking the completely wrong direction into
help me.
An ambush.
If you don't
Draconia.
Help me. Kill me!
Oh my god, Viconia is my favorite character. So, I just want to let you guys in. Baldur's Gate 2, Shadows of Aum, was my first Baldur's Gate game. Very first game I played, and I had it on, like, the computer, and it was, like, five discs. Yes, I'm that old. And, it was a difficult game, and as a kid, I never really got that far into it. I rarely was able to get further than the starting town, which is a large town. There's, like, six different map areas to this one town. It's amazing. Anyways, Viconia is in that game, and she can be a companion, she can be a main character, and spoiler alert for Baldur's Gate 3, everybody, turn off the video now. Spoiler alert, Viconia is also in Baldur's Gate 3. So, here it is, the first time we're meeting her in character. Calm down, we'll help you. Just tell us who you are. I'm totally getting rid of Bronwyn. My name is Viconia. I'm not from around here. Thank you so much for helping. Okay, what do we do?
I serve the flaming fist.
Oh, you're dead. Step aside, travelers. I am a member of the Flaming Fist. The woman you are harboring is wanted for murder of the foulest sort. She is a dark elf. It should be obvious that she is evil. They lie. I've done nothing wrong. All right. You'll have to get through us if you want her, because she is, like I said, my favorite Baldur's Gate character. She's such a bitch. I love her. I love Viconia. She is such a bitch. Don't be foolish. I represent the law of this region. By protecting her, you'll be just as guilty as she. Well, I guess that's too bad for us. I will destroy all of you Flaming Fist mercenaries. Anyways, Flaming Fist? Is that sexual? A stupid decision. For harboring a murderer, I sentence you all to death. Alone? Oh my god. Okay, just try to kill him quickly for his own sake, everybody.
Oh, my heart's really not in this.
Yeah, your defense spells didn't even have time to kick in, you guys. Okay, I guess we'll talk to Viconia. I thank you for risking yourselves on my behalf. I know what you are thinking. You see my dark skin and won't trust me for it. I am a dark elf, but I am an outcast. I need your help. I no longer receive my powers from the spider gods you surface dwellers fear so. The goddess Shar grants me wisdom, and she is a surface divinity. If you'd let me join your group, I would be most grateful. I have nowhere else to go. I will totally take you in, Viconia. Viconia, that's all you need. You just need to ask. I won't disappoint you, I promise. I know you won't. I know you won't. So, Bronwell was a woman who was like a stone statue, and then we bought like a spell from someone, and then we saved her. And so, you know what, Bronwell? Go live your life. You've been a statue for, I have no idea how long. Did they ever mention how long you were a statue? Could have been 2 weeks. Could have been 5 years. Could have been 30 years. I have no idea. Go live your life. Are you sure you want to remove this character from the party? Yes. Sure am.
Gorion would have none of this. It is shameful.
Is it shameful, Khalid? Bronwyn. We have fought well, and we have fought bravely. Tempest willing, perhaps I will fight at your side again someday. Okay. See ya. See you later. Let's... First, I want to check inventory, because I want to see what kind of weapons we're rocking. I've got a short sword and a short sword plus one. It's not great. It's not great, Jane. You're not doing great. Can you do anything else? I guess we can throw darts. I do have 20 of them. Oh, but what kind of armor am I rocking? Maybe that's where she's cool. Protector of the Second plus two. The Mist of Shadows were an elite group of elven rangers that roamed the Cormanthor Wood and were the bane of bandits and monsters alike. Armor class 8. Ooh. Armor class 6, but 8 versus piercing and missile. Nice. Nice. Okay, I guess that's where you don't, Jane, you are not wearing any kind of like rings or amulets? That is so strange to me. I've been playing Baldur's Gate 3 and my character is just covered in magic gear. Okay, Jaira. You know, I think I've just begun this game. I think actually as I was loading the game in, it said that I've only completed 10% of this game. And I feel like I've been playing several hours worth already. Okay, she's got plate mail and, ooh, Eyes of the Truth. Helm of Infravision, the eyes of, okay. Isn't she an elf? Can't she already see in the dark? Oh, protects against critical hits. Good enough. Good enough. Khalid, her husband. Remember that Khalid is her husband and she loves him very much. Looks like you have a medium shield and just a sword. Great. Great. Long sword. Okay, yeah, you're probably going to die. Get used to it. Imowen has studded leather armor plus one and a short bow. Now, she is a thief mage, I believe. So she can use spells, she just, what am I doing? She can use spells, she just, you know, I've got her using a bow. Plus, I don't think she can use spells while she's wearing her armor. Does Baldur's Gate 3 have that same... No, it doesn't. In Baldur's Gate 3, you can definitely have a mage... who wears armor. I believe so. Depending on how you mix and match the perks, maybe, or the race. Anyways, this guy is cool. Zahn, like I said, we met him just earlier. He's got a robe of electrical resistance. I mean, but who does electricity damage? He's got boots of electrical resistance, right? So you're pretty much 70% resistant to electricity. Cool. If we run into any electric users, I guess we know who to send. But he does have the Moon Blade plus 3. It's like this amazing blade. Only Zahn can use this blade. So, I can't use it. It does add to his armor class and fire resistant. Okay, so now he's 70% electric resistant, 50% fire resistant. Interesting. It's a dagger and it's one-handed. Okay, cool. But whatever, let's keep moving. Let's find this town, which I feel like... Oh. I see a cart. I see a cart of some sort. I assume it's going to be a small town, but still. Come on, game. So I've already reached the top of the map. You know, this is fine. I do this often. I wander around the edge of areas until I like figure out how big they are. That's not what I wanted. I want the area map. Okay, well, let me guess. The town is going to be here in this corner. Okay, let's go talk to Ted.
Hello?
Hey there, city folks. So what in the name of Lathander takes you so far from home? Well, we are adventurers. Let me get a little drink of water. You're adventurers? I used to have an uncle who thought himself as some kind of hero. He had the sword, shield, the whole bit. But he got himself killed, see? He was going off to kill some sort of beastie with all of his buddies, but something went terribly wrong. I guess his beastie figured out he was coming and set up a trap for him and his friends. So anyhow, there are him and his buddies trudging through the wilderness on the way to the monster's lair. Then all of a sudden... Bam! Smack! The monster leaps out and starts ripping off arms and legs. When my pop found his brother, there was nothing left but a big pile of rotting meat. Alright, cool story, bro. You got any advice for us? Oh yeah, I have lots of advice about adventuring. If you want to get rich, the best place to go would probably be the ruins at Firewine Bridge. If you want some action, why don't you give back some of that trouble those bandits have been dishing out on the coast way? Okay, does that... Okay. So I think that added more areas to our map. Oh, we're being addressed. It's your choice. Which hits the ground first? Your swords or your heads? Be smart now, and you'll live to grow wise. Are you guys bandits, or are you, like, police? I don't know. I don't know if you're bandits or police. Let's take them. Liar Jane. As you like, fool, that your children shall be orphans tonight. Yeah, Liar Jane does not really suffer fools. So, good luck.
My blade will cut you down to size.
Cut him down to size. Kill the leader first. Awesome. No one else wanted to jump in on that. Watch yourself. There's a strange magic around that Ardenor. Not like any hobgoblin I've seen. Okay. You guys, did I kill him so quickly that you didn't aggro on me? That's weird. Let's see if I can grab his stuff. Okay, it's like, there we go. He has a giant warhammer. I don't feel like picking that up. I feel like my character's nearing the edge of her carry capacity. I don't know if there's carry capacity in Baldur's Gate 1. I think you just have slots, a certain amount of slots to put your gear. I'm not sure if weight is a factor. Wood of sharp teeth. Okay. Wood of sharp teeth. Does that mean that there's like tons of wolves in the woods, or does that mean more like the woods themselves are gonna start attacking me? I cannot help but open up all this like dark parts of the map. Oh, cool. It's like some sort of spider thing.
Just for the fallen!
Destroy it, please. Yes, please, yes. Destroy it. Keep both of them. Thank you. I don't know if it'll happen in this episode, but oftentimes your companions will just start talking to you, and just like in Baldur's Gate 3, you can romance certain companions. You can piss off companions and they'll leave your party. Like, a lot of the same mechanics that are found in Baldur's Gate 3 are found here in the original Baldur's Gate. One thing I did want to point out, this is an awesome game. I love Baldur's Gate. I love the stories that the development teams have created over the years. I think it's been multiple. It hasn't always been Larian Studios. It was Interplay. Who did these first ones? Anyways, the point though, everybody, is that the devs and the people over at Baldur's Gate didn't have to create the universe. The universe was already created through Dungeons and Dragons. We all know that. What they did was they created a story within an existing universe, almost like fan fiction, right? And maybe like some dungeon master came up with a really cool frickin' story, and it somehow ended, you know, within Dungeons and Dragons and ended up being the game. I don't know. Okay. Bandit camp. Time to kill us some bandits. Oh. I've discovered the bandit camp. The largest tent should be the leader. Oh. Okay. Largest tent. What was I doing here again at the bandit camp, you guys? Am I killing all of you, or are we just walking in and... lots of ruins around here. Okay, I don't know if I trust you, Jane, when you say that you've discovered the bandit camp, because I'm not seeing it. What is that? Okay, here's a bandit. Let's go kill that guy. Yeah, everybody awkwardly run around. Oh, there you go. Kill them all. Kill them all, you guys.
I shall.
Leave none alive, please.
I have no desire.
This may prove difficult.
Zahn, get in on it, buddy. Slay that. Use your magic moonblade. Bandit scalp. I have been collecting those for some reason. I don't know if they'll come in handy, but I have been collecting bandit scalps. So when we do meet up with traders, I found that one of the best things to sell are... Oh my god, I'm gonna have so many bandit scalps. How many do I have? Are scrolls. Scrolls are just good money. So I've got a gem bag. Let's go ahead and pick up this gem, jam it in the bag. Same with this gem. Jam it in that bag. Why do I have all these letters? Okay, it looks like I've just been giving Jaira all of my... I'm gonna give Khalid some as well. There you go. Use that, buddy. Oh, I forgot Zahn can identify stuff. Okay, wait. We have a robe, a ring, and a wand. Okay, yeah. Wait, that's not what I want. Identify that, use the one identity scroll. Ring of Protection 1. Nice. Armor class and saving throws. Not usable by a wizard. Let's go ahead and grab that ring. Slap it on. I think she can't wear it because of her armor. Okay, let's give it back to Zahn. Go ahead and use that ring to stay alive, buddy. Okay, let's just walk around slaying all these bandits.
Onward, utility.
Slay him. I got the archer.
For sure! My blade will cut you down to size.
So, I'm gonna have Jane. Action. Okay. I'm gonna have Jane drink a potion. Unpause. Everybody protect Jane. Oh, Jane is feeling fatigue. I see. Can we camp here? Wait, you guys? If I want to camp here at the ruins of this place, is that cool? Can we camp here at these spooky ruins? Let us see. Oh, nice. Okay. Fight Jane's fatigue. Okay, let's go back. See how many more bandits we can kill. This is fine too because Jaira has an infrared vision frickin' helmet on, so. Okay.
Onward, utility.
My magic fails me. Let misery's
run. Get over there. Seriously, you guys? Jane doing all the work.
I shall.
Okay. delicious bandits. I bet these bandits. Why are all the bandit scalps blonde? It's weird, right? Okay, well, this looks like the biggest frickin' tent. Before we go in there.
What is needed?
First, who can heal Jane?
Jean-Claes?
Cornia can. Can you heal Jane? Let's go to your magic. You can. Let's do heal on Jane. Thank you so much. Now let's go into record because I believe Khalid has a level up. Yeah, level up, I got it. Oh cool, we get to choose one. Okay, well currently he's using a long sword and I don't really know what else I would care to give him. Oh! Well, I'll give him sword and shield style because that's kind of how I'm having him play. So, sword. Okay, who else? Who else wants to level up? Zan, would you like to level up? Okay, you've got no proficiency slots, nor do you get any new skills. I bet you get... Okay, mage spells. Pop over to Zahn. Do you get more? Oh, that's Faconia. Sorry. Zahn. You can charm people and do color spray. That's about it. If you knew two additional spells, we could do them, but you don't know those spells. Interesting. That's interesting. I'm going to try something out. I'm going to give Zahn a couple of spells. I think Jaira had a bunch of them. These are just scrolls, mind you. They're just scrolls, but he can't use that one. These buttons are weird, everyone. Okay, well, at least we have sleep now. Oh, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. I can write magic. Okay, I must already have that one. Okay. Okay, why was this one... Is that because he can't do... So it said that he was an enchanter, which I find interesting. Does that mean there's only certain spells he can handle? Okay, so let's look at that one. Let's write that magic. Okay, here we go. Here's a new mechanic I did not know existed in all of my hours of playing this game. No idea. That's how you learn new spells for your mages, your sorcerers, I assume clerics. Okay, so now if I go into his spell book, do I have additional spells? I do. I have Detect Evil. That's it, huh? All right, well, memorize Detect Evil, I guess. Okay. Let's... Shit. Okay, I think I need to pause, hit this button, unpause. There we go. I remember how to do this. Okay, let's go into the biggest tent and either have a conversation with or destroy a bandit leader.
Worry not.
Sorry, friend, but you've got a date down under.
His name is Ramon. I don't care who you are, no one's to enter Tazok's tent under penalty of death. And look, everybody, if you look closely, he's blonde. Why are all these bandits blonde? Am I in some sort of Nordic territory? All right. We are here under Tazok's own instructions. He requested that we retrieve his files and documents and deliver them to him as soon as possible. Oh, because I think this guy perhaps has to do with the iron shortage. And we probably found his secret documents in the Nashkel mines. Clever. Your petty lies are wasted on me, Liar Jane. Like Ender Sai here, you've crossed the Iron Throne for the last time. Okay, well, you're uninjured. What are you? You're Britic. Okay. And you're Venk. Let's kill the mage first. I have found in Baldur's Gate. Kill the mage first as quick as possible. There are so many mage spells in this game that are broken. And a mage can just destroy your whole party in like one round. So you gotta kill the mage first.
Go for my power overwhelms.
Kill him. Kill him. Kill him. Okay, not a brute. Not a brute. Kill that guy. Who else we got?
Really not in this.
No. You guys don't attack Ender Sai. Oh. Yeah, kill that guy over here. Ooh, got a couple more level up.
I shall.
Okay, let's grab that. I'll grab the healing potions. Let's actually have Zahn pick up some of these spells, and we'll at least check and see if they're the kind of spells that he could possibly utilize into his mage book. Okay, what else we got? Ooh, magic bow, magic arrows. Okay, I'm just trying to...
You look troubled.
Yep, just want Jane to pick up the scalp here, and then...
Yes, oh omnipresent authority figure.
I know that Khalid can carry a longbow, so let's just go ahead and grab the longbow. Okay. Okay, so yes, I guess this leader had something to do with the Iron Throne and the iron shortage. Let's talk to this bro, Ender Sai. Yeah, it's fine. No one open that trap, please. Thank you, Imowen, for the warning.
Troubled
times are upon us.
It's time then, is it? Time for what? Explain yourself. My execution, what do you think? You're not with him, are you, though? No, I'd smell his ransom breath on you if you were. You're right, we're not Tazok's lackeys. What's going on here? Aye, you're not. Well, this whole place is dirty to the core, that's what's going on. These aren't your ordinary bandits. They're part of Black Talons and part Chill. Chill being a demi-human band, mostly hobgoblins, and led by that creepy smart one, Ardenor Crush. Oh, we heard about that guy earlier. There be others elsewhere, like the priest Mulahay, sent to poison the mines of Nashkel, set himself up as a kobold god, returned, and legions of the brainless barking fools believed him, ready to do his bidding till death do they part. Okay, well, I killed that dude, and he was working for Tazok. So, who's Tazok working for? That's the trick, see? Crush and Tarsgaz Kosan, leader of the Black Talons, both think he's getting orders from the Zents, and Tazok doesn't do much to discourage that particular line of thinking. But the Black Talons and Chill are bandit groups, see? They ply the trade routes, avoid the cities, and that's where they go wrong. I'm from the Gate. Ooh, that's what, like, locals call Baldur's Gate, the city. I'm from the Gate, and I can tell you dead as leather that the Zentarim aren't behind this. How can you be so sure? A desire for silence isn't the only reason I wear soft-soled boots. I wear them so I can tell whose toes I'm treading on. I didn't mess with no Zentarim. I pick my enemies, and I mess with one group and one group only, the Iron Throne. And right as rain, here I am as Tazok's personal prisoner. You do the math. All right, well, Iron Throne, where can I find them? Tazok's been making regular visits to the Cloakwood, so that's where I'd start if I were you. There's some documents in that chest that might be worth taking a look at, too. Now, go step on some toes, all right? And you can tell him Ender Sai sent you. Awesome. Okay, Imowen.
What you want?
Would you please use your thief skills to unlock...
I've done had enough of this.
Okay. Gosh, more letters. Gauntlets, huh? Okay, I'll just pick up everything. Tazok, I hope everything moves along smoothly. I have written to give you instructions from our superiors. I have been told that a small band of mercenaries might cause the Iron Throne some trouble in the future. You are to ensure that they don't live to upset our operations. Obtain the services of the assassin Nimble. He should serve you well. Davirin. Okay, cool. What about this one? Tazok, I have noticed that your shipments of iron have slowed of late. It is imperative that we receive another ton of ore. Step up your raids and get a shipment to our base in Cloakwood within the next week. We need to stockpile as much ore as possible before our ultimatum is given. Also, Saravok wants to know what has happened with the band of mercenaries. Have they been killed? You had better ensure that they have been, as Saravok will not take kindly to any other news. Devarin.
Malay and Tazok have proven to be nothing more than puppets. The true master of this unfolding mystery continues to elude you. One thing is certain. Someone has taken a very personal interest in seeking your death. Though why, you are not sure. Your search for answers continues, and the foreboding Cloakwood Forest is your next target.
Okay, I'm back, y'all. Let's just keep to get outside.
Worry not.
Oh, I'm not worried. I am not worried, Jane. Oh, gotta use the stairs. Gotta come back out the way we came. Okay, I do want Do wanna look at the world map. Figure out where Cloakwood. Interesting. I probably have to first go to Friendly Arm Inn and then down to Cloakwood. That's usually how this seems to go. Otherwise, let's do a little bit of a level up game, huh? Let's level up Jane. Ooh, Jane, you get another slot. But she is a bard, so she can only do like one perk in each slot. Okay, so we got single-handed. Oh, let's do two weapon style, considering I'm currently using two weapons. I get another mage spell, but I'm wearing armor right now, so I'm not really using mage. Looks like my lore abilities went up, though. That's interesting. Jaira gets another slot. What would you like? Jaira, no. What is... She's already got a lot of good stuff. What do I currently have you using? Let's just give her... Okay, she probably has quarterstaff. Let's give you a double quarterstaff. I like Jaira using a quarterstaff. I think it's cool. Okay, we should give her a quarterstaff too, because I'm not sure she's currently using a quarterstaff. I think she's using a sword. Oh, and Viconia. Actually, before we level her up, what is her... When asked about her past, Viconia reveals, quite proudly, that she is a dark elf from the underdark city of Menzo Baranzan. She says very little about her reasons for leaving that sunless realm, though separations of such a nature are never gentle. She does claim to no longer worship the spider goddess Lolth, a change that even you know is often fatal. Her new faith is that in the night goddess Shar, an appropriate choice for a drow, though... This is not a firm indication that she has given up the brutal ways of her people. She finds the laws of the surface world quaint and a little more than a little strange, but this is simply because of her lack of experience. Likewise, she seems to be naive about how her race is viewed by surface dwellers. Many will not give her the chance she seems to expect. and even being seen with her may affect how people think of you. Oh, I bet. You know that as a drow, she has resistance to magic. Awesome. Level her up. Nothing, though. Her sling gets better, I guess. Cool. Okay, everybody, I think we're going to call it an episode there. I just kind of wanted to jump back into Baldur's Gate. You know, I've been having so much fun with Baldur's Gate 3, and I've got a long way to go in Baldur's Gate 3, but I'm pretty sure I'm close to the end of the second act. The end of the first act in Baldur's Gate 3. I'm pretty sure I'm close to the end. I just solved the problem at the Druid's Grove. So stay tuned to the Johnny Guitar channel for more Baldur's Gate and more Baldur's Gate 3.
My power overwhelms.